I'm super stoked. If you've been following this tractor project, we're going to wrap this thing up. We're going to have this Cummins engine blowing some smoke. Before we install this head, let's talk about its gasket. There's three common ways that you can blow a head gasket. So if you've got a puddle of antifreeze underneath your car and your mechanic tells you it's your head gasket, it's because your head gasket is allowing your coolant to leak externally. Or if your car is overheating due to a blown head gasket, chances are you've got a leak between your cylinder and your cooling system. If your car is running bad due to a blown head gasket, you're leaking between two cylinders. Like all the other bolts in this engine, we'll make sure we lubricate the threads and the shoulder, and we'll torque them to manufacturer's spec. It's important to follow the manufacturer's set patterns on the head bolts when torquing them. So we've got our head bolts torqued to 300 foot-pounds. We're going to go another 90 degrees with our 1-inch impact gun. We're going to lubricate the cam bearings and slide the cams in. Okay, so we've got our cams installed. The next step is to set the cam timing. And it's very important to set your cam timing properly because you've got six pistons running up and down. You've got 24 valves over top of those pistons. And if those things aren't in sync, you can have major engine damage. You've got two types of cam timing gears. You've got a fixed gear and you've got a tapered gear like this. Typically a fixed gear, you'll align with timing marks on the gears. This particular engine, you're going to use a timing wedge instead. What you do is you slide this down, there's a flat spot in the cam. It's going to lock that cam in place where the factory wants it to be. Boom, your top side's done. It's time to move on to the crankshaft. So setting the crankshaft timing position is pretty simple. There's a hole in the block. I have a timing pin. I'm going to slide this into the hole in the block. I'm going to rotate the engine slowly until it finds a hole in the crankshaft. So before we started this procedure, we intentionally left these cam gears loose. That allowed the gear to slip on the cam. So with our crankshaft locked down and our cams locked down, now we can lock these gears down, our engine's in time. All right, so we've got our bolts laid out and organized. Our next step is to install the rocker assemblies. So the next step is to install the engine oil cooler. But first, we need to take this cooler apart. We're going to take it over a solvent tank, and we want to make sure there's no debris left in that cooler. So when this engine's running, this entire jacket right here is going to be completely full of engine coolant. That coolant's going to circulate through these oil coolers and cool the engine oil. I don't know if you've ever seen a fuel pump, but this right here is an enormous fuel pump. You got a lift pump, you got actuators that supply the injectors, and then you got a fuel shutoff valve. It's time to install the turbo. If you're not familiar with a turbo's job is to enable your engine to burn the maximum amount of fuel. Exhaust turns the turbine side of this turbo, it turns the compressor side, force feeds your engine with air and oxygen that allows it to burn more fuel. It's also important to pre-lubricate these turbos. You never know if they've been pre-lubricated from the factory or not. It's time to install the lubrication system. This is the engine oil pump, and it's very important to prime your engine oil pump, especially if you've had it depart. Okay, so what we've just installed is a coolant manifold. In the first episode, we talked about cavitation that could be treated with additive. You screw the canister with the additive, it flows through, protects your cylinder liners. Alright, so now it's time to adjust our valve clearance. Valve clearance is the distance between our rocker arm and our valve bridge at low cam. It's very important to make sure that your clearance is set properly. If it's too tight, your valve might not close, you can burn a valve up. If it's too loose, a bridge might fall off and fall down into your engine. So the objective here is to measure the distance between the rocker arm nose pad and the valve bridge. And for that, we have a 14,000th feeler gauge. What we're going to do is slide that between the bridge and the nose pad, and it's going to tell us our clearance. We're getting close. Let's get the valve cover put on, get our tractor pulled inside. That actually do it. It's actually not a bad job. Now what we're going to do is hook the drive shaft up. We're going to bolt all the accessories on, get the wires and lines hooked up, fill this thing with water and oil, make it some smoke. So we've got our engine filled with engine oil and coolant. Next thing we need to do is pre-lubricate it. We're going to crank the engine with the ignition off until we get oil pressure on this gauge. Sounds good! Okay, so that should wrap up our tractor project. This thing's running good, sounds good, got good engine oil pressure. And if you like this, comment below, let us know. If you want to see more body work, let us know. If you want to see more fab work, let us know. And as always, for all your heavy equipment needs, it's SnoomanTractor.com.